Today we go into the next topic. I have Karen with me, helping me with showing you the basic stances, yeah, what we do today. Generally, we will always teach you step by step the structure of the stance, then how to bring it into movement, and from there, bring it into movement with different transitions and other principles combined with our Shenwu basic exercises. Yeah, we have 12 Shenwu basic exercises which teach you all in all different transitions from stance to stance, and of course also different stances, basic stances of Kung Fu, and how to move with it in space. Okay, so today our first part of this is the Mabu, the horse stance. Yeah, Ma means horse and Bu stance, or also step in. Yeah, and this is already giving a bit of a hint. It's not just about standing. With standing it starts to understand the structure and how to be with your body, but actually it's also a lot about how to transition from one stance to the other and how to move with the stance in space. Yeah, because this is when you go into application and want to use it. This is actually the important thing of a stance. Yeah, like Mabu is a lot about takedown defense, going low, defending, or stepping in and giving a long step into a jab, yeah, a punch. So this is why it's important to understand. It's not just about the stance, it's about all three layers we go now through with every basic stance. Yeah? Okay, so let's start. Now, starting with Mabu, Kerem is going into the basic Mabu stance. Yeah, and Mabu, as the name is telling us already, it looks a bit from the structure like you're riding a horse. Yeah. So, what is important in this stance? First of all, the feet look to the front. Yeah, they can slightly open also. Show it when they're slightly open. Yeah, but they shouldn't open too much like this. Then you do it too much, okay? So I say the best is parallel the toes to each other. And if you have problems to keep it parallel, I also rather recommend come a bit higher and stand rather parallel, then go really low and then open your feet too much, okay? So, but Kerem can do it low and parallel. This is the great thing, and this is why I have her with me today. yeah. The next point going more upwards are the knees. No, you can stay, sorry. The knees, if possible, you stand 90 degree, yeah? So the knee has an angle of 90 degree here. And you could put like something on the thigh of Kerem, like a stick. We will show this later, yeah, can stay there. The legs are around double shoulder width apart or even a bit more. When Kerem stands with the feet together and is opening two times, yeah? One, this is shoulder width, and two is something like double shoulder width, yeah? This is a good size to go into Mabu, but it's not like a must rule, yeah? Like, it can be a bit wider, it can be a bit closer.
Depends how low you go.
Depends also how low you go, exactly, yeah? And also it depends of your hip flexibility, okay? It's also a big part. I will say about this more later. So when Kerem goes into the Mabu now again, we can progress to the other parts, yeah, to the upper body, because even so it's about the legs, it's about the whole body, yeah? Every stance is always a whole body stance, not just a leg stance, okay? So Kerem's lower back is rounded. Yeah, the tailbone is pulling down, like in standing Qigong. The chest is dropping into the body. Yeah, so we have a slight round back, taking the bigger parts, the bigger curves of the spine out and creating like a bridge structure from the legs to the arms, to the head. The head is also, like in our basic Qigong, from the crown of the head, like you're pulled up. Like the head is floating up, like I always imagine a bit like a balloon, yeah? Like it's wanting to separate from the spine and from the head is stretching softly the neck, but not too intense. You should still have the feeling of lightness. Yeah? Like this lightness makes the whole stance light. And now, because I say it's a full body stance, in every stance I also want you to go into an arm position. Yeah? Here we choose for Mabu now Hunyuan Zhuang. This can be also other positions, but I like Hunyuan Zhuang because Mabu is also a lot about this roundness, about this expanding in between the legs. Yeah? So the knees pull to the side, press out slightly, so the knees are not falling in like this, yeah? But they press out, and the same is happening now here with the arms. We have a slight expanding between the elbows that pull you a bit apart, and this, yeah, filling, expanding structure. Okay, take also care that your weight is not completely on the heels, like you're leaning back, yeah, but you're actually leaning a bit forward, more towards the ball of the foot, so that the weight can travel through the Yongchun point, the middle point of the foot, into the floor. Yeah? You want to create a line between head, chest, pelvis, and the standing point, which is in a line between the two Yongchun points, yeah, under your pelvis. So this is, in one line, you guide the weight into the floor. Thank you for watching. In the next video, we bring this into step work. And yeah, thank you, Karen.